Bioinformatics Micromodules, the phylogenetic tree reconstruction problem. In this module, we define the phylogenetic tree reconstruction problem, discuss the complexity of it, explain some ideas for solving the problem, and introduce a string format for representing phylogenetic trees. First, let us define the phylogenetic tree reconstruction problem. The input to the problem is a set of sequences from different species or strains, the evolutionary relationships of which are to be inferred. Although we will focus on DNA sequences in our discussions, the methods that we will describe in the coming modules can also be applied to RNA or protein sequences. The objective is to find a phylogenetic tree for the input sequences such that it likely captures the actual evolutionary relationships between them. Specifically, this means the tree should contain the correct order of separation events. Optionally, we may also require the correct inference of ancestral sequences in the internal nodes and the correct inference of divergence time as indicated by branch lengths. Since we do not have the correct answer, we rely on some measures that can indicate how likely the reconstructed tree is correct, and we will discuss some of these measures later. In later modules, we will always assume that a set of input sequences is given as the input. Now, let us first take a moment to think about the sequences that are suitable for reconstructing phylogenetic trees. If we want to know how a gene has evolved, naturally, we would use sequences of the gene, say from different species, as input. What if we want to study species as a whole? The first answer coming to our mind might be using the full genomic sequences of the species as input. Although full genomic sequences do contain the largest amount of information, practically, it is difficult to reconstruct phylogenetic trees using them because of the great difficulty in aligning these long sequences. Instead, we usually use some short subsequences from these genomes as input to the phylogenetic tree reconstruction problem. To be qualified as suitable input sequences, these chosen sequences need to be available for many species, such as sequences that play key biological functions. These sequences should evolve relatively slowly, such that sequences from close species do appear more similar. Besides, each species should contain only one copy of the chosen sequence, for having multiple copies could confuse the phylogenetic tree reconstruction process. Based on these requirements, one popular choice is ribosomal RNA sequences that form part of the ribosome, which is required for the fundamental biological process of translation. So how difficult is the phylogenetic tree reconstruction problem? One way to answer this question is to count the number of possible phylogenetic trees. Based on this measure, phylogenetic tree reconstruction is indeed a difficult problem. In fact, since branch lengths are continuous values, there is an infinite number of possible phylogenetic trees that can be formed from a given set of input sequences. Even if we do not consider branch lengths and consider only the order of separation events, which is captured by the tree topology, we still have an exponential number of possible trees with respect to the number of input sequences. Here, two trees are said to have the same topology if and only if one can be converted to the other by two types of operation, namely changing the lengths of the branches and swapping the left-right order of sibling nodes. With this definition, we can easily see that when the input contains two sequences, there is only one possible tree topology. To calculate the number of possible tree topologies when there are more input sequences, we consider the case of three input sequences. There are only three possible locations to add a third sequence to the tree topology containing sequences 1 and 2, namely, the branch that connects the common ancestor of them to the root, the branch that connects sequence 1 to its parent node, and the branch that connects sequence 2 to its parent node. By definition, the trees produced in these three ways have different tree topologies, since they cannot be converted to one another simply by swapping the left-right orders of sibling nodes or changing branch lengths. In the same way, when there are four input sequences, we first pick a tree topology for the first three sequences, and then find out all the branches at which the fourth sequence can be inserted, and there are five of them. Since there are three tree topologies for the first three sequences, there are in total 3 times 5, that is 15 different tree topologies that can be formed when the input contains 4 sequences. We can use the same way to compute the number of possible tree topologies for larger numbers of input sequences. In general, when there are k input sequences, the number of possible tree topologies that they can form is the multiple of all the positive odd integers up to 2k-3, which is exponential with respect to k. For example, with 20 input sequences, this number is already 8 times 10 to the power 21. For unrooted trees, the way of calculation is almost the same as rooted trees, except that without a root node, with 3 input sequences, there is only one possible tree topology for an unrooted tree, since now in the definition of tree topology, instead of allowing sibling nodes to swap their left-right order, all nodes connecting to a common node are allowed to rotate around the node. Then, when there are 4 input sequences, the 4th sequence can be added to any of the 3 branches, leading to 3 different tree topologies. In general, the formula for k input sequences becomes the multiple of all positive odd integers up to 2k-5 instead of 2k-3. Although a little bit smaller than the rooted tree case, this number still grows exponentially with respect to k. Given the difficulty of the phylogenetic tree reconstruction problem, how should we solve it? As in the case of other computational problems, there are several main ways to deal with difficult problems. The first way is to define an easier version of the problem, for example, by making certain assumptions. An optimal solution to this simpler problem may not be optimal for the original problem, but it could be much easier to obtain. The second way is to design a smart algorithm or use a smart data structure to avoid redundant calculations, such that a polynomial number of steps are sufficient for finding out the best tree topology among an exponential number of them. The third way is to use a heuristic method, which cannot guarantee optimality of the solution, but is much faster. On the basis of these ideas, in the coming modules, we will describe 4 different phylogenetic tree reconstruction methods. 2 of them are sequence-based methods, which means the actual input sequences are needed for the algorithms. The other 2 are distance-based methods, which only require the pairwise distances of the input sequences, but not their actual sequences. The 2 sequence-based methods that we will discuss both use the ideas of simplifying the problem and using smart algorithms to find optimal solutions for the simplified problems, while the 2 distance-based methods both use heuristics. Before ending this module, let us discuss a string format for representing rooted phylogenetic trees called the Newick format. In this format, each node is represented by an ID optionally followed by a colon and the distance of this node to its parent, if available. The ID of a leaf node is simply a sequence name, with the ID of an internal node is a pair of parentheses embracing the 2 child nodes separated by a comma. Finally, a semicolon is added at the end of the whole string to signify the completion of the tree. For example, suppose you're given the following phylogenetic tree with 5 leaf nodes. Suppose the leaf nodes are to be recorded from the bottom one to the top one. The corresponding Newick representation is as shown. Please take a moment to study the correspondence between the graphical and string representations to get yourself familiar with the Newick format.